Hi folks, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode I'll be taking you through how to easily apply a hue saturation adjustment in Illustrator. Overall, we'll cover applying a hue adjustment, applying a saturation adjustment, and applying a lightness adjustment. If you want to apply a permanent uneditable adjustment, all you have to do is select your artwork, go into the object menu, scroll down till you find filters, Phantasm, and then choose Hue Saturation. For this tutorial, I'm going to go into the Effect menu, scroll down till I find Phantasm, and then choose Hue Saturation. By going into the Effect menu, I'm going to be applying this as a live effect, which means I'll be able to come back and make some changes to this in the future. I'm going to click on Hue Saturation, and that's going to bring up the Phantasm Hue Saturation settings for me. Over here at the top, it shows that we're going to be editing the master channel. Click on this drop-down menu and you could pick and choose each individual channel one at a time. I'm going to tuck this guy away. Now let's take a look at how to make a hue adjustment. When you're making a hue adjustment, you're going to be mapping your image to a new color. Over here at the top, you could enter in a specific value or you could use these sliders. I'm going to click and drag towards the left and notice what I'm doing here is I'm turning all my reds to blue and you see that effect over here in my artwork. I'm going to click and drag towards the right. And now what I'm doing is I'm turning all my reds to yellow and you see that effect over here in my artwork. Now let's take a look at how to make a saturation adjustment. When you're working with saturation, you're specifying the amount of your chosen hue. Over here, I'm going to use this slider to click and drag towards the left. I'm backing off on the saturation so you see less color in my image. Next, I'm going to click and drag towards the right and enter in a positive value and notice we have more color in our image. Next, let's take a look at how to make a lightness adjustment. When you're working with lightness, you're controlling the luminance value. Over here, I'm going to use this slider, click and drag towards the left to enter in a negative value. We're backing off on the lightness, so things are going to get darker. I'm going to click and drag towards the right, enter in a positive lightness value, and now it looks like I have a bright light shining on my image. We also have this colorize feature. Clicking on it once does exactly what it sounds like. It's going to colorize your entire image. Click and drag to map out the entire image to this new color. I'm going to uncheck colorize. Down here at the bottom, we have these basic options. All you have to do is use these tick boxes to pick and choose which elements should actually get this adjustment. I'm going to make one quick edit and then click OK once I'm ready. Over here in the appearance panel, notice we have this as a live effect, which means we could come back and make some changes to this adjustment in the future. I'm going to deselect my artwork so you can get a better look at it. And that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered applying a hue adjustment, applying a saturation adjustment, and applying a lightness adjustment. Make sure you watch the next episode in order to understand how to apply an invert adjustment in Illustrator. And don't forget, all of our plugins are available for a free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.